across Africa. Democracy, please put your hands together. Make some noise for Teju Babyface!
Factory 78 TV, we're live at the backstage for the Just Joking event with Wale Gates, with one of the special guests tonight. I'm sure a lot of people recognize him himself, all swagged out himself, Mr. Olateju Oyelaki. How you doing, sir?
Thank you. Hello! Disney, London. You guys look so nice.
Did I get it right?
So for you.
Did I get it right?
For your mind, you know Mary Shouse.
You know why I called you that? Because when everybody, for a long time, people were saying, Teju Babyface, Teju Babyface, Teju Babyface. Yes, you are Teju Babyface, the presenter, actor, comedian, producer, entertainer, extraordinaire. But you see, are.
If I got paid for each of those things, I'd be very rich. The way you said it, it's just one job. It's just one job. One job, one salary. That's just what it is.
You guys look so nice. Madam, I've been looking at you, corner of my eye all evening. The man beside you is your husband. Okay, Oga, this is about to say, don't take it personal. Madam, I want you to have my kids.
A lot of us here in the UK, we watch TV, we see what people are doing in Nigeria. You're one of the people that's on stage, on the cameras, entertaining us here. First of all, presenting and hosting such a successful TV show. Tell us about that experience.
I have some religious, it's just God, you know. The Yoruba say, if you read that, you say like me. Translation, you stay in your area of grace. So apparently television is my area of grace for now. The vision is yet for an appointed time. So when God says to move, then brother move. But you know, so if you read that and say like, we stay in your own area, stop trying to do somebody else's stuff. There's somewhere where you're supposed to be king. So ask God, he'll put you in that area then. I didn't say it was going to be easy, but you're going to shine anyway, so.
Yes, if you just send me your address, I'll bring the two of them tomorrow afternoon. You can keep them. I like to say that. People think I'm gonna, you can keep my kids here. Just come on like that. Well, I need what I asked for. I need that water. Give me that water. Thank you.
All right. You said you didn't say it was going to be easy. You've been doing this for a long time. I said actor as well. You're an actor and an entertainer in general. Look at me. Yeah. What other aspects do you bring to your hosting of TV that makes your show such a different and unique entertainment show?
Just me. I mean, I'm myself. I have no airs on the Teju Babyface show. I don't try to speak English that I do not know. I talk much the same way I'm talking to you right now. It's my show. It's called Teju Babyface Show. So I do me on the show. And apparently there is something to authenticity, which is why I'm saying you have to be yourself. I just bring me, my experiences, the Yoruba my father taught me, the proverbs my father taught me, the music my father taught me, the lessons my mother taught me, my experiences. I just bring myself to the show. That's all. I show up and then we do the show. It's just me.
You're a comedian. You've come here to support your friend, Wale.
You know, I remember when I told her I wanted to become a comedian. Now, when I first told her I wanted to become a comedian, she did the typical thing. Now, when an African parent laughs before they reply your answer, it means there is nothing friendly about that answer about to come out. Am I lying? I said, Mom, I want to become a comedian. You have just told your first and last joke. Will you get out of this place? And also, every time I used to go, oh, no, yeah, so I turned, I wanted to become a comedian. And she would be like, oh, we've heard that you're about sweet. She just went, she would just degrade it.
Wale Gates. Used to be a comedian.
Yeah.
Used to be a comedian.
But you still entertain and make us laugh. So once a comedian will always be one.
Probably. Kind of like David Letterman. I'm not sure anybody remembers the last time they saw Letterman do stand-up comedy. So it's a bit like that. I mean, always a comedian inside of you, but not always a performing comedian. This is a special favor for Wale. This, of course, is not, you wouldn't consider this a commercial event for me. This would be you coming out to see a brother. I may as well be attending the show. Then Wale would say, that's Teju Babyface in the audience. Come on for a few minutes. You know, it's that kind of stuff. It's just support for a brother, that's all.
That immigration thing that turns you people to phonetic speakers. When you come from Lagos, you talk like me. But when you get the other side, you develop better than both across the world, isn't it? It's annoying. See, if you were born in London, we forgive you. If you spent at least a dozen years, if you talk like that, we forgive you, Banshee. You get to a stage in comedy, there's nothing to hide. You'll be hiding Banshee, my throat gets dry.
Now, on your show, one of the unique...
By the way, I get to enjoy the next part I'm about to tell you. You have two questions left. I'm preparing for the show, yeah, so I have to be in my... I can't talk. Also, you have two questions.
One more question. Forget the two questions. Just one more. Just one more. Just one more. You bring entertainment and social issues together in a unique way. You interview politicians as well as people that mean well in the society. How do you mix that with entertaining the audience that watch your show?
Well, first of all, we have to credit my director, Tadio Gidon. What you see on Teju Babyface show in its final incarnation is not, it's not totally, it's not wholly my idea. I think that's the pronunciation of that word, wholly. Wholly. It's not wholly my idea. It's in the sense that when I brought my blueprints, my initial skeletal framework to Mr. Tadio Gidon, who was my director, he said, you know, this is good, but, you know, let's up the ante by tackling, you know, social issues and tackling people who would have things to say, important people in the... He said that way we're really going to catch people's attention. I thought he was bumped out of his mind. I was like, they did not listen to us. Like, that's a lie. Everybody wants to talk about themselves. So let's try. So we tried, and what you know, he was right. So I'd have to credit him with that part. And once we set on that part, and then I found that I could do it. I found that I actually had the questions to ask them. Did you see my eyes? My eyes did a camera thing. You're wondering what I was looking at. There's so many people behind. So that's why. Anyway, so and once we started to do it, I found that I could do it, and then we could do it. And so now we're doing it. Thank you very much. That being the last question.
Peace. Now, you're going to get ready. You're looking very well. We can't wait to see you on stage. Teju Babyface, we enjoy your show. Good luck with all your endeavors. Have a wonderful evening, sir.
Thanks, boss.
Isn't it normal that if you're under the lights and you're seeing what's on your nerves, you are bound to get thirsty at some point? Yeah. Uh-huh. We'll shake up my dear man.